Hi all, I am Disha Shukla and welcome to the session. In this session, we are going to see about the different mobile technologies and how they evolved. So, starting with the very first thing, that is the first generation, that is 1G. This was the first generation of the cell phone technology. The very first generation of commercial cellular network was introduced in late 70s. With fully implemented standard being established throughout the 80s. It was introduced in 1987 by Telecom, known as Telstra. Australia received its first cellular mobile phone network utilizing a 1G analog system. 1G is an analog technology and the phones generally had poor battery life and voice quality was large without much security and would sometimes experience drop calls. The maximum speed of 1G is 2.4 kilobits per second. The second generation of computers, that is the 2G. In this, the cell phones received their first major upgrade when they went from 1G to 2G. The main difference between the two mobile telephone systems, 1G and 2G, is that the radio signals used by 1G networks are analog, while 2G networks are digital. Main motive of this generation was to provide secure and reliable communication channel. It is implemented the concept of CDMA and GSM. Provided small data services like SMS and MMS. The advance in the technology from 1G to 2G introduced many of the fundamental services that we still use today, such as SMS, internal roaming, conference calls, call hold, and bill based on the services. Example, that charges based on the long distance calls and real time billing. The maximum speed of 2G with general packet radio services, that is GPRS, is 50 kilobits per second or 1 Mbps. With enhanced data rates for GSM evaluation, that is for edge, it is 1 Mbps. Moving on to the third generation, that is the 3G. This generation sets the standard for most of the wireless technology that we have come across to know and that we love. Web browsing, email, video downloading, picture sharing and other smartphone technologies were introduced in the third generation. The 3G standard utilizes a new technology called UMTS as its core network architecture, that is Universal Mobile Telecommunication System. 3G increased the efficiency of frequency spectrum by improving how audio is compressed during a call. So more simultaneously, calls can happen in the same frequency range. This network combines the aspect of 2G network with some new technology and protocols to deliver a significantly faster data rate. The next is the fourth generation. 4G is a very different technology as compared to 3G and was made possible practically only because of the advancement in the technology in the last 10 years. Its purpose is to provide high speed, high quality and high capacity to the users while improving the security and lower the rate of voice and data services, multimedia and internet over IP. The key technologies that have made this possible are MIMO, that is multiple input, multiple output, and OFDM, that is orthogonal frequency division multiplexing. The two important 4G standards are WiMAX and LTE. Now, based on this four generation, we have some comparisons to be made between 1G to 5G. So the parameters that would be comparing it can be the first one being location of the first commercialization. For 1G, it was USA. For 2G, it was Finland. For 3G, it was Japan. For 4G, it was South Korea. For 5G, it's not yet found. the definition. For 1G, it's analog. For 2G, it's digital narrowband circular data. For 3G, it's digital broadband packet data. For 4G, it's digital broadband packet with all IP very high throughput. And for 5G, it's not yet defined. The time period when in which these were found were, for 1G, it was between 1970 to 1980. For 2G, it was between 1990 to 2000, that is. For 3G, it was from 2004 to 2005. For 4G, it's now, that is transitioning to 4G. And 5G would be soon, probably after 2020. The data rate that each of them support is, the 1G supports 14.4 kbps, 2G supports 9.6 to 14.4 kbps, 3G supports 3.1 mbps, 4G supports 100 to 300 mbps, and 5G would probably support in gigabytes. The technology that was used in 1G is AMPS, NMT or ACS. For 2G, it was TDMA or CDMA. For 3G, it was CDMA or Edge. For 4G, it was WiMAX, LTE and Wi-Fi. And for 5G, it's not yet been found. Again, the multiple data techniques that are used is, in 1G, it was multiple access data that was used in 1G was FDMA. For 2G, it's TDMA and CDMA. For 3G, it's CDMA. For 4G, it's CDMA. The switching type that was used in them for 1G is circuit switching. For 2G, it's circuit switching for voice and packet switching for data. In 3G, it's packet switching except for the air interface. For 4G, it's packet switching. And for 5G, IPv6, but enhancements are still to be done. Some special characteristics of 1G is first wireless communication. In 2G, digital version of 1G technology. 3G is digital broadband and speed increment. In 4G, very high speed and all IP. For 5G, it's yet not defined. Some features in 1G are voice only. In 2G, it had multiple users on single channel. In 3G, it had multimedia features and video calls. In 4G, it was high-speed real-time streaming. In 1G, the internet services, there was no internet services. For 2G, there was narrowband internet service. For 3G, it was broadband. And for 4G, it was ultra broadband. And for 5G, it is yet to be seen. So this is all about how the different generation of wireless communication has evolved. What are the different features? What are the different characteristics that have evolved, and how they are helping humans, how they are speeding up the way we use data and voice. If you have any queries in this topic, you can contact me. Until then, keep learning.